Let's make a map of the solar system where the distances between all the planets are correct, right? They're to scale. And what's great about this is you can fold it up and put it in your pocket.
A solar system in your pocket.
Right.
Perfect so for space travellers like us.
Some colour pens.
All right then.
You're going to need a piece of paper.
Okay, so does it matter? Does it matter what size the paper is?
No, it doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter what size the piece of paper is. So what you need to do is fold this piece of paper in half long ways.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Done.
Perfect. And then again.
Again, yep. So once more. So that's the second fold.
That's right. And then once more.
Okay, so three folds.
Three folds.
Gotcha.
Open it back up again. What you'll now have is a strip of paper with eight equal size chunks in it. Okay, now grab a pen, orange pen, and draw the sun right at that far end over here.
Nice. All right then, so I'm just going to pop the sun just here. Is that all right?
Yeah, that's great.
Yep, I'm going to colour it in.
Now, in the middle of your piece of paper, so between the sun and this far end, you can always fold it in half again to find that where it is. It's this fold here.
Yeah.
Now, you want to draw Uranus.
Uranus.
So Uranus goes just there.
All right, so Uranus is going just here in the middle. We know that Uranus is a very cold planet.
Okay.
There we go.
Great.
Yeah.
Now what you need to do is in between Uranus and the end here,
yeah,
you do Neptune.
Neptune.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that was here, was it? So
yeah,
smack bang between the
between
end
Uranus
and the middle.
And the end, yep.
All right.
Good job.
Neptune, thank you.
Then what you need to do, I'm trying to keep track of this, between Uranus and the sun, that one's Saturn.
Well, if it's Saturn, then we've got to put some rings around it.
Put a ring on it.
As Beyonce would say.
Yeah. And then between Saturn and the sun, you do Jupiter.
Here.
Well, just here, you see that fold. Actually, it's just to the side of the fold.
Just to the side of the fold.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah,
all
perfect.
Right, then.
Do Jupiter. Nice and big.
Yeah.
Great job. Yeah.
Hang on. I'm going to add that red spot. More.
Add the red
I'm
spot.
Gonna, it's blue, but you get the idea. That's our storm. Nice.
That's one. Okay, good. Right. Now what you need to do is you fold this end piece in half once again.
All righty. I'm going to do that. Okay, so I folded the end. Like
good.
So.
Now, along that fold, that's actually your asteroid belt. So put just a couple of little bits of, so they're lumps of rock that are flying around.
Okay.
They're obviously really little in comparison.
Teeny, 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 teeny.
Okay, great.
Little
now,
asteroids.
In this space here, you've got to fit Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars all in that little space there.
Okay. All right, so.
So squeeze those in.
So just in this little teeny
space?
Yeah,
just in that little space there. So and remember, what we're doing here is a
Mercury.
Scale model of the solar system, of the distances between the planets. And this is actually, again, I ran the numbers, I did the maths, really, really quite accurate. One thing that isn't accurate, though, is we're drawing all of those planets in a long line, and the planets are never all in a long line. They're actually all going round the sun, and not in a perfect circle, in like a squashed circle that we call an orbit. So they're actually all flying around as an orbit.
Done
and
it.
There it is. You have done it. Now, what works really well is to actually label them and then you can fold it up, put it in your pocket.
Wow.
How cool is that? Here's one. Here's one I made earlier. Here you go. Let's flip back to this camera. That's labeled up.
It's really amazing to see that all of these rocky planets are super squashed up here. And then look at how far everything else is spread out. That's impressive.
Isn't that super cool?
That's really, really interesting.
Get creative as well. You could do it on black paper. You could do it with some chalk. And I just wanted to show you this.
Sure.
This is a website from NASA.
Mm-hmm.
And on this website, you can actually see the positions of the planets right now. How
nice.
Cool is that? Right now. And you can rotate it round. You can look at kind of the distance out. You can travel into the inner. It's really, really cool.